Hi, I'm Rick Kirby, Vice President of Sales and Marketing here at Renkus-Heinz, and I'd like to give you a quick demonstration of our ICONYX Generation 5. Now, ICONYX digitally steerable arrays allow us to create very tight beams of sound that we can focus, almost like focusing a flashlight beam. And we can then electronically steer these beams so they cover only the intended audience area in the room and don't hit any hard surfaces, for example, a glass back wall or a hard balcony front. And by avoiding those hard surfaces, we avoid reverberations and echoes, which will ultimately affect intelligibility and people's ability to understand what's being said. Now, in this example, we have an IC16, which is our 2-meter tall column. This one can throw clear, intelligible sound for about 40 meters or 120 feet. I've programmed this one with a 10-degree beam on driver number 9, which is right about here in the loudspeaker. And rather than lowering and raising the camera to take you in and out of the beam, I'm actually going to spin the loudspeaker horizontally and we'll move the camera in and out of the beam so that you're virtually walking in and out of the coverage.
Modern electroacoustics began in 1915 when E.S. Pridham combined a telephone receiver and a phonograph horn into a loudspeaker capable of covering a large crowd at a Christmas Eve celebration in San Francisco. By Harding's inauguration, just after World War I, the Bell system was capable of providing sound reinforcement to the inaugural crowd. Converting telephone moving coil receivers into loudspeaker drivers attached to phonograph horns and so covering large audiences led to serious laboratory work directed at improving speech reinforcement sound systems. During World War I, two financial groups in the United States realized that the infant...
Well, that was ICONYX Generation 5. Thanks for watching. If you'd like more information, please visit our website, www.renkus-heinz.com, or call one of our sales reps for a demo.